Central Salt and Marine Chemicals Research Institute, Bhavnagar, is a national laboratory under the umbrella of Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, New Delhi. The discipline of wasteland research has been working on development of non-saline wastelands through cultivation of traditional oil-yielding plants, including Jatropha carcass, a potential biodiesel plant. Jatropha is a perennial open-pollinated medium-sized tree. Both male and female flowers are present in the same inflorescence. Female flowers are surrounded by male flowers and pollination takes place through insects, mainly ants and bees. After pollination, female flowers develop into green-colored fruits. As they ripen, they turn yellow and later turn dark brown at maturity. Normally, each fruit contains 3 seeds. The seeds are a source of non-edible oil which can be converted into high-quality biodiesel. CSMCRI has played a pioneering role in promoting the concept of Jatropha cultivation on wasteland and presently has more than 50 hectares of such cultivation with different accessions collected from different parts of the country and in 2 agroclimatic zones, Orissa and Gujarat. In the process, CSMCRI has identified few provenances with consistent and high yield. Large-scale nursery was raised mainly through cuttings from selected provenances. 20-centimeter long branch pieces were kept in raised bed for developing rooted cuttings during February-March and transplantation was done in the field during rainy season. The plantation established with selected accessions in Neswat Bhavnagar on wastelands has started fruiting profusely in the first year itself. From 2 hectares block plantation, a total seed yield of 1 ton was obtained in the second year, of which a number of plants have yielded as much as 2 kg seeds. Similarly, the plantation raised with selected accessions in Mahuda, Orissa on wastelands, provenance CP9 has been consistently giving high yields since last couple of years. Provenance CP13 was also seen bearing fruits profusely. Supports were provided to plants to avoid contact of fruits with soil. Most of these plants have fruits in bunches of 10 to 25 in number. Large number of plants yielded in the range of 2 to 3 kg seeds during the year 2008. Single seed weight and oil content in the seeds obtained from this plantation was also quite high. Attempts were also made to make the unproductive plants productive with the use of chemicals. Tissue culture technique was standardized to multiply selected high-yielding genotypes through shoot tips, nodal segments and direct organogenesis from leaves and petiole. Direct rooting in shoots under controlled conditions was also attempted to reduce the cost of multiplication. The rooted plantlets thus developed were transplanted in the field to assess and compare the performance with seedlings and cuttings and found to be more homogeneous and superior. The true-to-type nature of these tissue-cultured plants is being monitored through DNA fingerprinting. Various agronomical trials, particularly fertilizer and spacing trial, are being conducted to determine the fertilizer requirement and plant density per hectare. During field trials, various diseases and pests were observed and their prevention and control measures were identified. Intercropping with cash crops like castor and local pulses was undertaken to supplement the income during initial 1 or 2 years. The harvested fruits are thrashed out to get 65 to 70% seeds, which are crushed in oil expeller to extract about 30% oil. A process has been developed to convert oil into Jatropha methyl ester or biodiesel through trans-esterification. The PCT International report on patentability of the process has been favorable, and all claims have been accepted with respect to novelty and non-obviousness. Our institute has licensed the fully integrated biodiesel plant to RSSML Udaipur and DRDO Secunderabad on a turnkey basis. During the zero effluent process developed by the institute, various products like de-oiled cake, glycerol, soap, and potassic fertilizer are obtained. De-oiled cake of Jatropha, obtained during the preparation of biodiesel, has been used as manure in various crops like sesame, cotton, pearl millet, as well as Jatropha, and found to boost the productivity. The biodiesel prepared by CSM-CRI process complies to EN 14214 standard and has undergone various stringent trials. It has been successfully tested as a superior fuel in a number of vehicles like bus, tractor, cars, heavy earth moving machinery, and stationary engines. Use of biodiesel dramatically reduces hydrocarbon and particulate emissions in the vehicle exhaust. As its flash point is high, it does not catch fire easily and is highly suitable for use in vehicles running in sensitive areas like airports, forests, and other environmentally sensitive zones. Recently, Jatropha plantation has been raised at Talegaon, Maharashtra, in the premises of General Motors under a collaborative project. Though a lot of efforts have been made to study Jatropha system, extensive research is needed to understand the benefits and risks associated with it. This is what we are striving for.